guys, I'm the Broniac here, and welcome back to the Final Fantasy V four-top Fiesta run. Last we checked, we were trying to get the signal for our Windrake buddy to finally land. I guess, much like in between last part and the beginning of this one, had a bit of a rough time trying to land, even when they knew that it was on the nose of the pool village. Oh well. And yeah, rather than staying with all of its Moogle buddies, the Moogle, specifically with Krile, decides to stick with Krile. So, yeah, take that as you will. Also, probably not sure if I mentioned this yet or not, but I actually tried to get some people to join in with this video, but obviously with little to no success. So, I get the feeling this automatic at this point. Well, so far. So yeah, it's automatic at this point. Could be the case. As I was saying, I was trying to get some people to join in with these videos, but to no success, so what I'm going to do is, in the next session, I'll try and do that again. Otherwise, I'm going to wait until the absolute most. If not once I get to World 3, then definitely once I'm going into the final dungeon, I'll definitely do that. Just so you know, because much like diabetes, I can only keep this up for so long, and I'm pretty sure you want to hear more people than just me. And yes, in case you couldn't tell, Galuf was a king from another world. What's the situation with Exodus? Well, it's been a while since we played Ultima 3, so there's not much we can tell you. I see. And the troops completely wiped out by the floor there. I'm sorry, sire. We probably should have gotten much better levels. Well, he's still a crazy old man, but that's what makes him great. And when you think about it, pretty much every person you play as in this game is a member of the royal family, with the exception of Butz, who's really just the son of a knight who served royalty. I better mind my P's and Q's around you, King. Busted you in the chin. Just Galuf. And I still prefer Ball, because if you're saying Ball is like what, Bale? Belial of that one. Okay, long live the king, slice off his head. Just saying. Hero cocktail, which we'll never use. We learned our precious teleport. But if I'd known that, I would have gotten the opportunity to name Butz Mario. You know, teleport, Mario! Yeah, she just has that talent. She's got the touch. She's got the power. Yeah. Anyway, puns aside, yeah, actually, after that whole punishment, yeah, I deserve that. Ow. And what's in here? A save point. It would not open no matter what you try. Probably because it's locked from the inside. So why is it that we can't go in? Well, in here is the mighty Odin summon, but it's locked up. But that doesn't mean we can't go into battle against Abductor, which is a strange name, but I still prefer that over its original name, Rock Statue. Yes, drain that MP for him. And also, I get the feeling they are already stoned, so it's not really gonna break them anyway, so what's the point of that? Let's just continue on with the battles here. Also, they are incredibly strong. Oh, no wonder it's not draining any more mana. It's already dead. Wow. Wow, you're actually far more powerful than I thought, so let's just... And it can cast break, so yeah, keep that in mind. And I can't cast Pesina. Well, fuck. I was gonna say, don't you dare petrify someone who's about to... ready to unpetrify someone. Yeah, not enough MP, big shot. Am I just gonna die from petrified party members? Because I won't be so upset if that's the case. So what I'm just gonna do instead is just bio. I'm not really expecting to win this battle, just really showing it off, if nothing else. And... and I get the feeling they're floating, so not really supposed to do that. Let's just cast Shiva on everyone. Ow! Diamond Dust. Oh my god, they just will not die. I'm actually gonna take this chance to see how much health they have, because at this point, I am curious. Let's see. Oh, good lord. A little over 3,000. So, yeah, that really should not surprise me. So, you don't need to use items, just heal. Yeah, keep doing diamond dust. We cast ice on the entire party of enemies, and finally that one is dead. And that one died too from his death. It might be because they're immune to it, it might be because it just missed a whole dead thing. Either way, I can be hopeful. Damn! Man, that was strong damage it did to it. So yeah, you do Cura on everyone. You cast Cura on Galuf. He can use it. Thank you. Damn, they hit hard and they want to. You just go back to summoning Shiva. Couldn't put him to sleep, but Diamond Dusto! Well, the good thing is, once we get to World 3, when we're supposed to be fighting against them, we'll be ready. This is just to show it off. Actually, let's try, you know, I realized I probably should have tried it on someone else, just in case again, Tempted Tangle, or Tangle Temptation, whatever it is. No, I'll take Jitterbug, Drain Effect. Did fairly decent damage, too. And it's dead, but I like to think that's purely because, and yet they already have Sap, so I may as well switch to Drain at this point. Oh, no, 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 no. I'm learning from my lesson. And Swordance, so now you're doing extra damage, which is pretty terrible, because you're all the way in the back row. And even then, you're attacking someone who's in the back row. So, yeah, you're doing nothing to that. And ow! How dare you! Thank you. this is the long episode, which this episode is going on for so long I want it to end. I should think about healing you. Just say. We continue on with the battle here as we keep using our Durian effective abuse. And you've been put to sleep, but it won't matter because our Berserkers is leaving. Like so. And put to sleep, but that's okay. It woke up just to be put to sleep again! Okay, here we go. Tempting Tango. And it's not affected by it. Big shot there! Oh wait, he's got drain. I don't feel him. Just keep doing what I'm doing best. Attacking! Maybe it's just a one-time thing? No. It wasn't affected by it. So yay, finally dead. I can actually survive this fight without a problem. Stop casting a spell you can't cast because you're already out of MP. So yeah, at this point I may as well just do because unless it does something extremely powerful against my party members, I don't think it's going to make that much of a difference. Especially if my Berserker blocks it. And let's try to cast Death on someone. Definitely died. Well, if nothing else, it's worth 8 ability points. So, give that credit for what it's worth, if nothing else. So, I get the feeling, once Butz masters Berserker, I'm just gonna make Galuf, and Butz switch jobs. So I think at the rate, Ferris and, Raynor are going, they'll just keep swapping off between Summoner and Red Mage for the time being. And then, because I get the feeling, base-wise, they already have pretty balanced, stats, but Galuf and Butz are the main attackers here. Anyway, I probably should have been healing while talking about that instead of just dragging this on longer outside of the battle. And won't open no matter what we do. We know the drill there. So at least we showed that off. And we shall continue onward in a moment. Let's just go down here because not many people will know this, but there's actually a spare blade that you can get here. A great sword lies here, aka, unless they named it something else, should be the Regal Cutlass. Which is right around here in the corner. Right there. Come on, just saw it. You saw that one. Oh. There. Greatsword lying in water. Which. Oh, they don't name it a Regal Cutlass. It's literally just a greatsword. I still. I'm probably repeating myself over this, but I love the fact that in Disgaea, if you got a greatsword, it would mention something like, it's great. It's a sword. It's a greatsword! Although, I love, my favorite one has to be the Bastard Sword, which is a sword wielded by a really big jerk. That one, for some odd reason, always made me laugh. It's just a little stuff there. That's the one that always gets me. It's a shame, because if Disgaea wasn't a long RPG, and I'm not saying long by once you get to level 99, you automatically beat the game. No, you can make it even harder. And by making it harder, you can level up even further. In fact, if memory serves, the highest level you can get in Disgaea was 9,999. That should not be possible by anyone. And yet, Disgaea found a way to do so. And you're telling us this now. only telling us this now. And an angel robe, which should be perfect for... Specifically for the chemist? Well, that's a shame. I could have sworn that it was just a rope anyone could build. Well, no matter. White spells, we don't need to worry about because we can't cast them. Black magic spells, that's just stuff we already got. Wait, is it just the same level 4 stuff as before? Yeah, we don't need to worry about any of those. Also, I noticed there was a switch on that wall, which, of course, now that I noticed it, I'm curious. I have to know if it exists, and I probably would have had to go to the other side there. So, excuse me if I'm doing this wrong, or just doing it wrong. aha! See, I thought that'd be the case. I am a shopkeeper! Oh, I want a shop! Yay! I got a free Lamia heart! Which I cannot use, but hey! Free gil! So I'll take it for what it's worth. Yeah, remember that gil? I want to sell it back to you. What will you give me for it? All of a sudden, the guy's looking at me like, you asshole. I just gave you that for free, and you're making me buy it back. Such a dick! Such a dick! And there was nothing to get there, but I'm pretty sure there's stuff to get here. I'd rather keep my chance for evasion up there. So, let us see what we have over here. It's just an inn. With an item shop, which I will check later or now. Now we don't have many soldiers left, but we have plenty of soldiers who can march back and forth in a small frickin' area. Yeah, you just think about that for a while. Just think about it for a while. If you do, I promise it'll make sense. 50 gil, that's such a ripoff, but I'm gonna take it anyway. I just freaking hella rich from selling the Lion's Harp, so why the hell not? Such an asshole. Okay, let's see if I can get at least, 39. Yes, I can! So now I have 50, and same thing for you. Can I get at least 50? Just barely, but it counts. So restock everything in 50. So for now, as far as items go, we should be fine. And notice that we're not getting any more tents, so we might as well buy as many cottages as we can. Three. Did I use the last? I think I did use the last tent, so... Shame. Oh, they're still asleep. So yeah, let's do that. And now I can get another cottage. Huzzah! And Anthers... found a use for them yet. Granted, yet, I'm pretty sure as we continue on in our merry adventurous quest, that'll eventually kick into play. So, nothing really much to do except to say hi to Krile and her adorable mugshot, because it's adorable. It's so precious. Exertion. focus there. Drakenvale. Let me see. What do they call it in the other one? Valiant Dragon. I'll take Drakenvale. I'll give you that one. Quelp. I'm going to give you Drakenvale. That was genius. This one and Kelp, not so much. Yes, together we'll be alright. We have plenty of items. We'll be just fine. So you just stay nice and confident, Krile. We'll be fine. And Windrake, you just keep murring. You, just keep doing that thing. It'll be fine. Now, what you do... yes, we're ready to go. Under no circumstances should you let me back in. No matter what the cause. Do not let me come back in. Under no circumstances should you let me in. Abductor? You're not the Abductor! I know Abductors. You are no Abductor. Liar! Liar! Such a filthy, dirty liar. Jitterbug, will that wake him up? No, it won't. Perfect. I'll let you do the first strike. Now, are you susceptible to break? Yes, you are! And notice how, even though there were three of them, we only fought one. Okay, let me back in. Let me back in. Let me back in. I know I said don't let me back in, but I wanted... God damn it, let me back in! But no, all joking aside there, I think if we go to the left, yeah, there's the area we can go to from there. Oh, it's already set to auto battle, and are you slowed as well or just sand? Couldn't really tell. I think that was it. But anyway, here's the next village, Quelb. Anyway, yeah, I got everything. Just to make doubly sure. And the only other thing I need here is a boar. But if memory serves, I don't think you can get that unless you're a trainer. So, yeah. Not really necessary. We don't need to worry about the boar. I'm not even gonna get it off camera. Truth to tell, you only get the gourd if you, sell the, both the frog you capture, Cornago, if it's still called Cornago, and 10,000 gil. Otherwise, you can't do anything. And notice all the doors are locked. There is absolutely nothing you can do here. So worth a visit! Except we can go into this one. Oh, already locked. Or is it? Oh no, 'tis Wolfmen! They engaged us all. They would show your blades and fangs as well. Kelgar, I'm still a bit iffy on his mugshot. It could be worse. But granted, it could still be better. Yes, they are friends of Exodus. They truly are. Galuf, you fool! Yes, I will settle this man to man, or in this case, man to wolf man. Pine attack. I'm sorry, that doesn't really look all that... Oh, okay. It's just to show that off. And pretty much, it's just a showcase. Yeah, no matter where he is, that one is there. Well, it's a fight he wanted. I just wanted to give him what he got. Yep, I'm a dick! You're welcome! But yeah, you get an achievement just for that. Literally called Lupine Attack. And again, what the hell's bells? What is with that reference there? Mm-hmm. And yes, they're both shocked by that, because big shock, even though Butz was born in his own world, Dorgan, his father, came from this world. So, technically, even though he's still native to his original world, in a sense, he's half a legal alien. Okay, I lied. That's old Cyan. Dorgan is old Cyan. And, oh good lord, Zazat, what the hell happened to you? That is just... I'm sorry. Yeah. In fact, your character sprite looks better than your mugshot. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. It should be much better. Dorgan, they can't do it without you. If you want to do this myself, I have plenty of power. Oh, okay, you're not joining me. This is Sparta? Or Sparta? It's madness? And yeah, just do a cutaway with colors, just to make sure that he's in there. That's just fine. It's not necessarily a bad idea to make sure that there's one here to keep an eye on him for as long as he could, anyway. Oh well. Yeah. Beat the game for me! You can do that! Can't you? I never requested that, but we'll take it anyway. Well, after you got punched in the frickin' throat by Butz, yeah, I wish you could help us, but that's not gonna be the case. So yeah, what's this guy here? I forget. Do you get an event here? Or am I thinking of at the pub or inn? If this place even has a pub. Frog, the frog. And there's a man here. And that's where the trainer bit comes into play. And apparently the frog, the wolf's name was Suze. Okay. Yeah, can I get entrance? That's just white magic. The same white magic. That's black magic. The same black magic. And I get the feeling if I were to go over here... Yeah, the same time magic. Don't need to worry about that. So I think what I'll do is I'll get a quick look at both the armor and weapon shop, and from there we will call it the parts. And what do I have equipped as a helm for him? Wizard's hat, which I think ups... Ferris's magic. So I think I might just keep that at bay, and this is basically just the same. Slightly newer stuff from here, where the only difference was power armlet, don't really need. Maybe the twist headband, but then again, if the red mage is going to be just a healer, probably not really necessary. And other item stuff, or maybe that's just and I can use buy that to cast bio, but then again, since I already have bio as a spellblade ability, I kind of get the feeling it's not really necessary, unless it attacks everyone, in which case I'll think about it. And also, oh yeah, that was the armor shop, so never mind. IR smart, folks. Remember, IR smart. So the only real item of interest would be the poison rod, which I would just buy multiples of, but so far, not really necessary. Insanity. This is madness. And, my exact thoughts from the sheeps. Bah. Bah. Oh, this is the event I'm thinking of. Sit down, sit down. I prepared some of the finest dish for you, and it's specifically from there. Which, if memory serves, I think, he'll restore HP for free, and then get some extra tonics. Up to 3 other times, so... If anything, this is my free in-visit, and I get some spare tonics with me. And by tonics, I mean potions, which, since I'm already at full, not really necessary. Because, yeah, already at full there. But, just for ha-ha's sake, let's just see what is in the item shop. Basically the same vanilla items that we saw in every other shop here. Although, oh, actually, yes, I should think about getting some holy water, because although not really necessary now, you never know. It might pop in soon. So let's just get a quick sword of that. Yep. And no need to heal, so let us just head right to the gate here. Well, what are you guys doing? Three wolves running after each other. Oh, and we now learned the Requiem, which again we'll never be able to use because we are no bards. And yeah, you just go back to your little dance ritual there. Anyway. That is going to do it for this episode of Eizen Tries. Eizen Tries. It only took me till part 17, but it finally happened. I thank you for watching the Final Fantasy V 4-Job Fiesta. Good lord. I wonder if that's a sign I should stop for now. Knowing me, I'll probably get at least one more part before I call. I think you know what I do at this point. I'm just going to stop this video before I embarrass myself further. Take care, and I'll see you all later, folks. Oh, goddammit.